Welcome. This video discusses testing your Facebook local currency payments implementation. When testing the user flow and order fulfillment sections of your payments implementation, detailed in parts 3 to 6 of this video series, it's natural you'll want to make test purchases as you iterate on the development of your solution. Making these payments with a real payment instrument, like your credit card or PayPal account, could quickly become very expensive. Thankfully, Facebook allows you to assign specific users of your app to be payment testers. If a user is assigned as a payment tester, they can make transactions as normal within your app. However, their payment instrument will not be charged, and the transaction will not appear in the payments reporting API. Payment testers can be defined in the payments section of your developer app settings. Once a user is listed here, they will see a checkout flow with two simple options to complete a payment, either successfully or unsuccessfully. In terms of order fulfillment, test payments will perform in exactly the same way as non-test payments, with the JavaScript callback, real-time update, and payment graph API performing consistently. The only difference is that when querying the graph API for payment info on a test transaction with a payment ID, an additional test field will be added to the graph API return data, set to 1. This signals it was a test transaction which will not be paid out for. In addition to testing your payment flow works generally, you may also wish to test payments in specific currencies. Doing this by changing your preferred currency on Facebook is tedious, as Facebook limits the frequency of changes to help prevent fraud. We have therefore added the functionality for developers of an app to test purchases in multiple currencies without having to change their preferred currency in their payment settings. This will only work for admins, developers, and testers listed on an app to avoid potential abuse from users through JavaScript injection. We have added an optional parameter when invoking the pay dialog called test underscore currency. When calling the pay dialog, if you set this parameter to the 3-character code of a supported currency, it will temporarily override the currency which you are usually charged in. An example of how to do this can be seen here. My default currency is Great British Pounds, but I'm manually overriding to Swedish krona. Note, this only overrides the user's default currency and does not mean that every transaction will be a test transaction. This gives you full flexibility to make both test and real transactions in any currency. Of course, be sure to remember to remove this parameter when going into production. Finally, it can be useful to A/B test payment flows within your app. This might be when trying out different pricing strategies, items for sale, or user purchase flows. In order to accurately measure results, you need to segment users in a way that provides a fair baseline from which you can measure differences. Facebook has created a simple API to assist in creating these segmentations, dividing users into 10 even groups. You can simply query for the payment underscore test underscore group field on the user object in the graph API. Facebook will return a number from 1 to 10. So for example, if you wanted an A/B test between two flows, with 50% of users on each side, you would show flow A to those with a payment underscore test underscore group value of 5 or less, and flow B to those with a value of 6 or more. Facebook has taken steps to ensure this segmentation is truly random and represents an even distribution of users' pay profiles, generating reliable, consistent results. For more information about testing payments, please see the URL listed here. Thanks.